previously on Alternative History.
And that question is, what would have happened if Napoleon had conquered Russia? Hello YouTube, this is Dragonheart and welcome to episode 2 of Alternative History. In last week's episode, I asked you guys what would happen if Napoleon conquered Russia. And I have to say, the response has been fantastic. Plenty of suggestions have come in, plenty of great ideas, and I'm going to read a few of them here for you guys today. So Skipper Total War says, I think Napoleon would still have been defeated as he couldn't invade Britain. He tried and failed multiple times because he couldn't transport a large army thanks to the Royal Navy. Prussia may have surrendered, but it would be difficult seeing as Britain was applying so much pressure. This would allow time for Wellington to win the Peninsula campaign, and from there Britain can attack France from north, south and west. The only major thing that would change, 1812 would not be considered a stalemate, as Britain would actually be able to take back the USA, with no Russians to appease. New Orleans would slow that down, but in overview it certainly did nothing to the overall strategy besides inspire the people. I am certain Britain would have taken USA and also given land to the Native Americans, as they promised, seeing as Russia and Prussia did not need appeasement, considering they were both steamrolled. So, excellent. Thank you for the comments. I'm going to read another one for you guys. We have Snowchill. Snowchill said, personally, I would probably have given more land to Krakow and left the rest to the Tsar, along with a guarantee that he would blockade Britain. After that, though, he would eventually lose. Prussia was feeling pretty patriotic at that point, and Russia's manpower is pretty much endless. That, along with Britain's cash, would have started the war pretty soon. Napoleon would probably have still defeated them for a while, but with his health getting worse and the Allies adapting to his strategy, the result of the Napoleonic Wars would still be the same. And I'm going to read one more for you guys here. This is from the Rogue Empire. He said he thinks if he had taken Russia, Prussia would have given up. Maybe not immediately, but eventually. He thinks England would have fought for a long time and only surrendered when Napoleon invaded Britain itself. And if he kept beating them in battles and took many cities. Once all of mainland Europe was under his control, there wouldn't have been anything to stop him from taking Africa and the East. This is all assuming he didn't lose a huge amount of men to the cold and battles of Russia, which is what really did him in. He lost too much in that campaign. So guys, thank you so much for the response and the questions that you have submitted for this week. There are 7 questions in total. I can't pick all of them. What I will be doing is doing a draw later on, and I'll pick the winning question for next week out of the draw. If you guys would like me to keep your submitted questions in the pot for next week or the week after, I will keep them there. Although if you do want to submit a new question, that's great too. If you do, leave a comment below with the new question. But now it's time for me to answer last week's question. What would happen if Napoleon had conquered Russia? Personally, I think not a lot would have changed if he had conquered Russia. I think he probably still would have lost a lot of men. Russia, let's not forget, Russia is a massive place. Attrition is one of the main factors when you go to war in Russia, as Hitler found out many years later. Napoleon would have lost a lot of men. He might have taken Moscow, he might have taken other places in Russia as well. But additionally, he would have struggled still to have found reinforcements. He might have put a puppet on the throne of Russia, on the Tsardom. One of the main reasons why I think Napoleon still would have failed is because he had so many enemies. He was at war in the Peninsula campaign, he was at war in the coalition campaigns. I just think for one person to conquer Europe, because that's pretty much what it would have led to, is Napoleon conquering Europe, would have taken so much for one person to do. I don't think he would have been successful. He might have had some short-term success by conquering Russia. I just think, personally, it was a stupid campaign. He would have been better off probably going west rather than going east, going to the Peninsula War, helping out there, conquering Spain. I think he would have got a lot more by conquering Spain than conquering Russia. But alas, history didn't turn out quite the way we wanted, or quite the way we have suggested in this video, and things turned out differently. He went to Russia, he lost lots and lots of men. I think it's something like 4/5 of his army was wiped out. I'm just speculating, but one of the figures I've seen is 4/5 of his army. And, you know, that's what happened. Okay, so it's time for next week's question. I have my trusty pot right here. 7 questions in here altogether. I've numbered them, I folded them up into a paper, and I will do a draw. So here we go. I think that's Hawaii 5-0. Right, we have a question in my hand. And that question is number 4. What would the world be like if Persia won the Battle of Marathon? This question was submitted by the Rogue Empire. Thank you for submitting the question. So next week question, what would the world be like if Persia won the Battle of Marathon? Thank you for watching, guys. I've been Dragonheart. Hope you've enjoyed. I'll see you next week. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.